Morning everybody, I'm Kavita, Department of BCE, Government College of Engineering, Bangalore. So now I'm going to handle a session on classification of signals. So before proceeding with the classification of signal, let us see first the definition for a signal. A signal is a function of two or more independent variables that carries some information to represent a physical phenomenon. So now the example of a signal are electrical signal, acoustic signal and noise signal. Even image and video are examples of signal. So electrical, acoustic and noise signal are examples for one dimensional signal because these depend on only one independent variable, for example spectrum. Image is a two dimensional signal because each pixel in an image depends on either both x and y. And in video, the video signal can be represented in terms of three independent variables x, y and z. Hence it is an example for a three dimensional signal. So now I am going to give the definition and some example for the classification of signal. A signal can be classified in many categories. Some of them are given here: continuous and discrete time signal, deterministic and non-deterministic signal, periodic and aperiodic signal, causal and non-causal signals, even and odd signals, energy and power signals. So first let us see the continuous and discrete time signal. So what we mean by a continuous time signal? If a signal has its value for each and every time instant then it is a continuous time signal. So the duration varies from minus infinity to plus infinity. That is, the signal will have a value from minus infinity to plus infinity for all the time instants, then it is a continuous time signal. Now what is a discrete time signal? If the time is discretized, that is, the signal won't have a value for all the time instant, rather it will be discretized. Here the x-axis will no longer be t, that is time, because it has been discretized and now the x-axis is represented as n. So this is an example for the discrete time signal. As you can see, the signal doesn't have a continuous value, rather it has values only on some discretized time instant. So this is an example for discrete time signal. Okay? So the first classification is over. The next is deterministic and non-deterministic signal. So the name itself implies that we can determine the value of the signal in prior. That is, the deterministic signal can be expressed mathematically, or we can predict the behavior of the signal in prior. Okay? For example, x of t equal to sine 3t. If we substitute different values for this variable t, we can predict the behavior of the signal in prior or in advance, so that we will come to know about the behavior of the signal. These kind of signal are called the deterministic signal. The signal shown here is a discrete time deterministic signal. Okay. So the next is a non-deterministic signal. And that is, we can't predict the behavior of a signal, means it is called as a non-deterministic signal or a random signal. A noise signal is the best example for a non-deterministic signal, because we can't predict the behavior of a noise signal in prior. So here is shown a noise signal. So the next classification is periodic and aperiodic signal. So what do you mean by a periodic signal? If a signal satisfies the property of x of t plus t equal to x of t for all t. What is the meaning of this? If you consider this waveform, okay, so now Let us consider the waveform from 0 to t. What is the value of the signal from 0 to t? From here to here, it has a triangular shape, and from here to here, it has a zero value. So this is considered. This is considered as one time period of the signal. Okay. So now, if this signal repeats again and again from minus infinity to plus infinity, then we can call it as a periodic signal. That is, x of t you consider this as x of t, that is the signal value from 0 to t. Then in that case, okay, the same value repeats again, that is x of t is equal to x of t plus t, that is after the time fundamental period it repeats again. So this is an example for the periodic signal. Now what do you mean by an aperiodic signal? Simple, if the mathematical expression which we have seen before is not satisfied, then it comes under the aperiodic signal or non-periodic signal. Okay, so here I have given an example waveform. Now why we are calling it as a non-periodic signal? If you see the signal value, okay, so now it has a triangular shape, and after this its value is 0, and its value is 0 up to infinity. So this signal is not repeating, rather its value remains the same up to infinity. So this is an example for a non-periodic signal. So now on the left hand side, the signals presented are aperiodic signals, few examples, and similarly on the right hand side, the signals presented are the examples for aperiodic signal. So now coming to the next classification is the partial and non-partial signals. So a partial signal is the one if the signal is present on the positive time axis, then it is called as a non-partial signal. So now, if the signal is present on both sides, then it is called a non-partial signal. There is a special category in this classification, which is called the anti-partial signal. So what do you mean by an anti-partial signal? If the signal is present only on the negative side, then in that case, the signal is called the anti-partial signal. So students get confused in this category, that is they confuse with the non-partial signal and the anti-partial signal. So a non-partial signal means it will be present on both the axis, that is time axis, whereas an anti-partial means it will be present only on the negative time axis. So here this is the same examples in terms of discrete time signals. The previous example I have shown you the partial signal example with respect to continuous time signal. Now it is again the same one in case of discrete time signals. The next classification is even and odd signal. So what do we mean by an even and an odd signal? So if a function satisfies g of t equal to g of minus t, what is the meaning? A signal should have the same behavior on the positive x-axis as well as on the negative x-axis. Okay. So now this point is taken as the reference. Okay. So now this point is taken as the reference. So if you see the value of the signal on the positive side and on the negative side, they are both same. So the signals on the left hand side are examples of even functions or even signals. Now consider the odd signal. What is the expression for that? G of t should be minus of g of minus t. What is the meaning? The signal values present on the positive side should be negative value, should have a negative value on the negative time axis. Now you consider again the reference is this axis, y axis. So if you consider here this case, okay, the second one, from here to here the signal is increasing on the positive time axis, whereas on the negative side the signal value is decreasing, which means g of t equal to minus g of minus t, which is an odd signal. Okay. So the last classification is the energy and the power signals. So now, how can we define a signal to be an energy signal? If a signal has a finite value of energy and its power is zero, then we can categorize it as an energy signal. So now, energy can be calculated by means of this mathematical expression, or simply it can be stated as area under the square of the magnitude of the signal. So now, what we mean by a power signal? Okay, if a signal has a finite power value and its energy is infinite, then we can call it as a power signal. And the power of a signal can be calculated by making use of this mathematical expression. Now, what is the importance of classifying the signals or finding out a signal, whether it falls under which category and so on, is that if we know the behavior of a signal, we can determine the output of a particular system. That is the importance of finding the classification of the signal. Thank you for listening. I think this will be useful for you.